I welcome you back to YSVU channel. I am Dr. Yusuf Anif Sheikh, Associate Professor, Department of Physics, Shivaji College, Kannur. Today I am going to teach you Origin of Quantum Theory, Part 3. I am covering the Planck's Radiation Law, Wien's Law, Rayleigh-Jeans Law from Planck's Law and Photoelectric in order to explain the spectral distribution of a black body radiation over the range of all wavelengths. Planck derived radiation using the revolutionary idea of quantization of energy. According to quantum theory, energy is emitted in the form of packets or quanta called photons. Each photon has an energy h nu, where H is the Planck's constant and nu is the frequency of radiation. According to this theory, the body does not emit or absorb energy continuously but only in discrete units called quantum or packets. The energy absorption or emission takes place in integer multiples of the energy of a photon, that is h nu. Planck deduces nu radiation formula by considering the interaction between the radiation inside an isothermal enclosure and electric oscillator, which he imagines to exist in the walls of the enclosure. Planck's radiation law, E nu into d nu is equal to 8 pi nu square into d nu upon c cube multiplied by h nu divided by e raised to h nu upon kt minus 1, whereas nu is equal to c upon lambda. Now, if we take derivative of this nu, that is a modulus of d nu is equal to modulus of derivation of this c upon lambda, that is minus c d lambda upon lambda square. If we substitute these values, then we get equation e lambda is into d lambda is equal to 8 pi h c upon lambda raised to 5 multiplied by d lambda upon e raised to h c upon lambda kt minus 1. Wien's and Rayleigh-Jeans law from Planck's law. The Wien's formula and Rayleigh-Jeans formula can be obtained from the Planck's law. Wien's formula from Planck's law. Planck's law at lower temperature or low wavelength lambda t is small and hc upon lambda kt is large, so that exponential hc upon lambda kt is greater than 1, and 1 can be neglected in comparison with it. Hence the Planck's equation becomes e lambda into d lambda is equal to 8 pi into hc upon lambda raised to 5 multiplied by d lambda upon e raised to hc upon lambda kt. Rayleigh-Jeans formula from Planck's law. At higher temperature or high wavelength, that is lambda t is large and hc upon lambda kt is small, so that the second and higher order terms of hc upon lambda kt in the expansion of exponential hc upon lambda kt can be neglected, and we obtained e lambda into d lambda is equal to 8 pi hc upon lambda raised to 5 multiplied by lambda kt upon hc into d lambda, that is equal to 8 pi kt upon lambda raised to 4 into d lambda. Photoelectric effect. When an electromagnetic radiation of sufficiently high frequency, such as ultraviolet light or X-rays, is incident on a metal surface, electrons are emitted from it. This phenomena is known as photoelectric effect, and the emitted electrons are called as photoelectrons. When the voltage across the plate is varied, the current also varies, and the curve showing the variation of current with the voltage is shown in the next slides. This is the curve of a photoelectric current with a voltage. When the voltage is increased, the current increases till it reaches a saturation value. This will happen when all the emitted electrons are controlled by the plate. If the plate C is kept at a slightly negative potential, there is a decrease in photoelectric current at a certain reverse voltage. The current is zero, and Vs is known as a cutoff voltage or stopping potential. Now, when the intensity of incident radiation is increased, the current increases, implying a greater emission of photoelectrons. The value of cutoff voltage remains the same. It gives that the maximum kinetic energy of the emitted photoelectrons does not depend upon the intensity of incident radiation. If the frequency of incident radiation is increased, then the cutoff potential also increases. Indeed, the maximum kinetic energy of the emitted electron EVS varies linearly with the frequency. There is no time lag in the process. It is very instant process. In the first sight, it appears that the wave model for light is also able to explain the photoelectric effect. However, there are some properties of photoelectric effect which cannot be satisfactorily explained by the classical model. The properties such as the maximum kinetic energy of the electron does not depend upon the intensity on it. It depends on the frequency of greater intensity leads to a larger number of photoelectrons to emit the further. There is no time lag in the process cannot be explained by the classical model. And thank you, dear students, for your patience listening. See you again in the next video. Till then, bye bye. Take care.